When looking across Italian filmmaker Luca Guadagnino's 6 feature films, you can begin to see stylistic and thematic consistencies within his work, the most significant of these being his communication through film as a language. When making a film, Luca wants to communicate ideas to the viewer. He doesn't do this by simply explaining what is happening, rather he will often choose to show the action, or let his actors embody the emotion of the scene.
He's not going to tell me what he's thinking about.
This can be seen at the end of 2009's I Am Love, when Emma Reki, played by Tilda Swinton, rushes home to pack her bags before leaving everyone behind. She bumps into her daughter, Elisabetta, and the two stop in their tracks. The film builds to a crescendo as the two of them look to each other, Elisabetta silently communicating that she understands her mother's desires to follow her heart, as she too had done earlier. This scene is how the film ends, not with a massive action-filled climax, but with resolution in the emotional, delivered in subtext. In an interview, Luca described his approach to filming as voyeuristic, always being the outside observer looking in on his characters and the action. It is in this manner that he also films the world and the people in his worlds. Every one of his films are beautifully composed, showing the beauty in the mundane. The landscapes, his characters, and of course the picturesque Italian scenery are all on full display in Luca's films. A significant reason as to why his films resonate with audiences so much is because of the strong emotional peaks that his stories reach, with relationships and situations that we can understand and relate to as an audience, transcending the literal bounds of the film into our own personal lives. Whether that be in the heartbreak of a love that goes away and Call Me By Your Name, and feeling the need to prove yourself in a new location in Suspiria, or in the feelings of awkwardness and discomfort that come from being around your ex in a bigger splash. Of course, Luca doesn't stop the parallels to real life with just the emotional aspects of his films. Rather, many of his films are set against a larger political landscape in order to highlight issues in society, giving the audience even more to think about once the film is over. This is found in A Bigger Splash, where, running throughout the film, there is a B-story showing the discrimination that the government holds towards the illegal immigrants from North Africa into Italy. This is also seen in Suspiria, where Luca chose to remake the cult classic 70s slasher film as a more realistic, arthouse drama, while still retaining elements of the horror and violence that made the original so popular. He also chose to focus very heavily on the setting, that being 1970s Berlin. This political landscape proved to be a strong choice for the film, going so far as to locate the dance academy that the main characters inhabit directly across the road from the Berlin Wall. The films do not make explicit statements on their stances towards the issues being presented, but nevertheless, the inclusion of these issues acts as a means to encourage discourse on the issues and to provoke further thought. The feature films of Luca Guadagnino are emotional stories with characters, ideas, and references to situations that mirror realities in ways which feel natural and encourage further thought. The detached presentation in his films of an observer looking in reflects a beauty that is hardly found in modern film, and reflects Luca Guadagnino's status as one of Italy's most interesting contemporary auteurs.